Hello everyone, this is Wisconsin Greg. Today I'm going to take you along with me. I'm going to go over to the Rock River Thresheree over near Edgerton, Wisconsin. I've been there several times and before in other years, and I love it there. So I figured I'd take you along with me for the ride. I'm sure you're going to love it. Excuse my videotaping, it's going to be a little shaky. I'm in the vehicle right now, and then when I'm over there, I'm not going to be using the tripod. But I'm thinking that you're going to like it no matter if it's shaky or not, because it's really interesting. So just wanted to let you know what I'm doing today. And I'm going to flip the camera around just for a couple minutes before I get there so you can see kind of what it's like around here. I'm coming up to Johnstown Township right now. So I'll just show you what the lay of the land is a little bit around here. Lots of corn and soybeans growing in this area. And I'll wait till I get through Johnstown so you can see the land a little bit better. So I'm going to put you on pause here for a second, and once I get through the township here, the Richmond or Johnstown Township, well, it'll only take a second because it's just an itty bitty township. There's not much there. Now I'll start the camera up just for a few seconds so you can see what it looks like around here. Okay, I'm back. I'll see if I can flip this camera around. Okay, this is Rock County that we're in right now. This is some of the best farmland in the area. I live east of this. The farmland where I'm at is not as good as this area. This is probably some of the best farmland in the whole state of Wisconsin. The sad thing about it is Janesville is expanding and taking up a lot of the farmland, and unfortunately it's the best farmland. Too bad they can't expand on the farmland that's not good like this, but it's just the way it is. Lots of unusual stuff here. It's always fun to come here. If you're ever near Edgerton during Labor Day weekend, I'd highly recommend coming here. Sorry for the shaky video, because I'm not using the tripod today, but I think you'll still find it pretty interesting. And they come off from all over to come to this show. think that was all because it's noon. I'm not gonna hit every tractor, but I'm gonna show you most of them. Big majority of them. We're getting into a few of the old steam engines. They're pretty cool. That was before the tractors we know of now today. They're really big. gotta be careful where I'm walking around here. The little pathways and stuff are really rough from the lugs on the tractor tires and on the steam engine wheels. You can see it's pretty rough around here. Every day they have a parade. I believe it's 2 o'clock, and anybody with a tractor here that wants to go through the parade, they can, and they announce what kind of tractor it is and what year it is. I think just about every one of the tractors goes through the parade. It's a pretty long parade. It's pretty interesting. I've seen it before, so I'm not gonna watch the parade today, but I'm showing you most of the tractors now so you can see them. A lot of them have tags on them so you can see what they are and what year they are and stuff. So here comes the Rock River Cannonball. They take people around the park for a ride. A steam engine pulling it. Here's the sawmill running. They're running it with this belt. Long belt hooked to a steam engine over here. Cuts through just like butter. All kinds of things to see in the park here. I'm gonna head over to the blacksmith shop, see what's going on over there. There's lots of people over here watching. Heating the metal up cherry red and then forming it to whatever they want to make. Years ago they made horseshoes and door hinges and latches and all kinds of stuff. They had to make their own stuff. Here's some of the stuff that's been made here.
I'm getting nervous. That makes me nervous. Oh,
yeah. You just don't want to be in your way.
Oh, you're not. I know you could.
Oh. that I don't like salt crosses. I just don't cook much with them. I don't plan anything.
Spent a lot of time canning and baking.
Yeah, a lot of
them. I think that one is Coco Bolo too. And that's left. That's
way down here.
There's something for everyone here.
Oh, I'm
pretty cool stuff here. My grandparents used to haul milk and cans to town in a sleigh like this years ago. Even a section of old cars and trucks and vehicles. Look at that one, old Oscar Mayer Wiener Mobile. I used to have one like this when I was a kid. Mine was a 56. Look to see what year this is. This is a 49. But I had a Chevrolet 3100 in 1956. Y'all don't mind this being a long video. There's a lot to see here, so it's going to be a little bit long. I used to have a truck like this too, an International 1200, 1970. This is exactly the same year. Mine was all black. That was years ago. That was when I was in high school, 1980s. Mechanic, we had one of these in the shop with a big old push bumper on the front. Used to push a lot of cars around with that thing. Old International Scout. Big old Lincoln convertible, Continental, pretty nice shape.
I drove by the place. I was driving and I looked and I saw a bunch of old cars out in the field and stuff and they were all like wrecked and I was like, what's that one? I was like, that's that place that burned down. I was like, drove right by it.
I was
like,
this medicine for a couple weeks to see how it went.
So now we're shipping stuff over in the case, then in the quarters.
Oh boy.
Then we're bringing it back. We got pro metal doing stuff for us.
That ain't a good setup.
I'm going to grab myself a bite to eat here, get myself a corn on the cob, and then probably a brat in a little bit. There's something for everybody here. I just had some sweet corn and some apple cider, and I'm gonna get a brat a little bit later here. Here's a steam-powered pile driver used years ago to put in foundations for bridges and stuff to pound those big logs in right there. You can see, looks like it might be starting up pretty soon. I'm warning you, it might be pretty darn loud, so watch your ears if you got your earphones on, or turn your volume down. As you can see, this isn't an all-man event. There's lots of women here running the equipment too. Here's a little sign telling about it. I'm not sure if you'll be able to read this or not. While we're waiting for it to start, I'll leave it on here for a few minutes. Hopefully you can get a little history about the machine. And here they're selling ground cornmeal and ground buckwheat. Right here, over here, is where they grind it. An old DeKalb seed corn bag here hanging on the wall. My dad used to sell DeKalb seed corn for many, many. Looks like it's finally gonna start. It's gonna be loud. Hasn't really started yet. It really gets going once it gets going. There. You feel the ground shaking here. It's like an earthquake. Squirting water at us all. Some amazing power there, driving a pulse that big into the ground. Bigger than a pulse is not called a log. How they drove foundations in for bridges years ago. Here's a stand selling sorghum syrup. My dad used to sell or raise sorghum when I was a kid for silage for the cows. This is some sorghum right here. It kind of looks like corn, a little bit different though. They make syrup out of it. I guess it's got a heavy sugar content. Here's some more of those hit and miss engines. Thank you. hear they're cutting off little sections of the log so you can hang on your wall, and then they paint Rock River Thresheree 2017 on it. And every once in a while they hand one out and give it to somebody. One right there. Pretty cool. Steam engine on each end. One way down there. One here. These weren't originally sold this size. These are made by somebody. These are what they call half scale. Now I got it running. See the blade over here spinning? Like butter.
they sawed off here.
I think this is a plane, I'm not sure. Every year they feature a different model tractor or make a tractor, and this year it happens to be Alice Chalmers. Kind of fond of Alice Chalmers because my dad had Alice Chalmers. They helped build the farm. When I took over after my dad, I had two Alice Chalmers 185Ds. I don't have them no more. I now have a New Holland. But I still love the Alice Chalmers. I got rid of the Alice Chalmers because the dealer closed in my area and I had to drive too far to get parts. They're not really, I don't even think they really make Alice Chalmers. They don't make them anymore. They're under some other name. They all kind of got together and merged together. Can't remember what they're called now. I don't know if they have it. They're Aco Alice or what they call them right now. My dad used to have a D19, I remember that. This here is a 1963, I'm not sure what year my dad's was, it could have been the same. That was the year I was born. Dad had one of these when I was young too, a WD-45, I remember that. Kids go for a tractor ride. Some of them have never been on tractors ever in their life before. Pretty cool that they can go. They're letting them drive them. better set up down here like was during the Civil War. And then they got a bunch of military vehicles over here also, older military vehicles. Pretty cool. All kinds of stuff here at the Rock River Thresheree. My battery's getting low, so I'm gonna try to conserve. Some old chainsaws here, some of you might be interested in.
She had a big, rumbling so-and-so collection on the back. And I said, boy, so you guys must have a few of these. Oh, yeah, she says. So that's my dad there. And we decided to start showing him again because he wasn't anymore.
The parade is going on right now. It's a really nice area. It's sloped up on each side of the pathway here. People sit on both sides watching it. The parade will probably be an hour and a half, 2 hours.
They're on a 1939 Al Shelmer's Model B, Bill and Donna Starford.
I'm not going to stay here and watch the parade though. I've seen it other years. I just wanted to show you where it is and how they do it.
Over here, Mikey.
It's amazing how this place has grown over the years. It's just amazing. Every year he's getting bigger and bigger. I'm gonna go get myself a bratwurst here. First, I wanted to show you there's a huge, huge rummage sale here, a flea market. It's huge. It's I don't know how many rows, but there's a lot of stuff here. I'm gonna walk around it. I'm not gonna film all that because my battery is getting pretty low. But just wanted to show you. So if you're ever in the area, I would stop by and check it out. This is where I always come and get a brat. I always like to help the Marine Corps out. Anytime I can help the military personnel out anyway, I try to do that. So I'm gonna go in and get my bratwurst now. Well, I made it back to my truck and I'm gonna be heading out of here. Just wanted to say thanks for joining me. I apologize for the video being a little shaky here and there. I did because I didn't use no tripod. I was just carrying it. But hopefully the content was good enough to keep you interested. So just wanted to say have a nice day, everyone, and thanks for joining. And I appreciate y'all watching my videos. Have a great day.